Financial sector J2S, and for the intellectual content we use the classification of profession ISCO categories 100 to 342. That means manager and technician and professional. So these ones. So how many are the IPs? Independent professional. We can see that self-employed workers are almost 15% of the total working population. Self-employed without employees 10%, around 10. IPROs are 4.4, and IP, so with this ISCO characterization, so only the high professionals, are 3.3%. They are more present, proportionally speaking, in Italy, in UK, in the Netherlands, in Belgium, and Greece. And they are the most dynamic because if we look at the trend between 211 and 215, while working population grew about 2% and self-employed without employees 1.6%, the IP grew of 13%. Main sector are arts and professional activity, and also real estate, which is quite small sector. But if we look at the recent growth, at the recent growth in the last year, the sector who increased more are social services, while usually in the past year were business sector. With the high education, of course, accordingly with our definition, so they are 70% they have a 70% university degree, double than salaried employees and almost double of employers. Okay, so let's have a look at the survey. We couldn't make a probabilistic sample because it was not possible, so we used a snowball sampling technique, and we had an online questionnaire between 15th of June till the end of September. And for the dissemination, we used the association of IPs, unions, cooperatives, LMIs, social media, mailing lists, newsletters, and so on. So due to this technique, we have some biases, of course. So first of all, the self-selection of the respondents, as usual, and so respondents are often weaker. And then, due to the distribution channel, the respondents are usually closer to the organization that disseminated the survey. And that means that in some countries, respondents belong to few professional categories, and in other, they use only few type of employment contract. And then we collected very different number of questionnaires in different countries. So, altogether, we collected almost around 2,000 questionnaires in 8 countries, because we couldn't reach the UK. And in Belgium and France, they are mainly salaried entrepreneurs or people working through LMIs. While in Sweden and Germany, they're working mainly in publishing and journalism. Spain, Slovenia, and Sweden are quite small sample. While in the Netherlands and in Italy, we had a good sample, but in the Netherlands a little bit more old people, and in Italy more women. So we decided to weight these two samples using Eurostat data. So, who are the respondents? Are IPs working in services, not trade, not retail, but also no finance, health, and mail regulated activities because we couldn't reach them. Okay? And they are both self-employed without employees, but also salaried workers who work under umbrella company or LMIs, cooperatives, and so on, just only in Belgium and France. But besides all the difference we have seen, we found some common result in all the country, in all the 8 countries. And that's what we are looking at. So, what are the key factors? First of all, they are high skilled. Then they are multiple workers. They want to be independent. They are genuinely autonomous. They are isolated with very low income, poor welfare, and we will see what they think about representation. So, start for the first one, high skilled. So, more than 80% have a university degree, so more than in the European data. More than 70 or 80% have more than one activity, and around 40% have 3 activities or more. Why? Sure, because it's more and more difficult to define boundaries between profession, but also because market require adaptability, but also because a job is not enough to make a living, and a lot of them we have seen that make other activities in completely different sector, like food services or craft or something like this. So multiple jobs have double significance, so in positive, demonstrated that IB are able to adapt themselves to the market requires, but also in negative, it could be a risk of progressive despecializations. So independence. We asked them if they prefer to be independent or not. And the majority of them prefer to be independent. First, motivation to be independent, and at the same time the first things that they said when they talk about satisfaction are the independence in itself to do the work they love and the work-life balance. So we try to measure the independence, and we use 2 kind of criteria. First of all, a subjective criterion. We ask them, how do you perceive yourself giving a vote from 1 to 10? And then objective criteria, we use 6 parameters. We ask them if you have more than one client, if you use your own tools, if you can decide where you work, when to work, how, and the holidays. So, how do you perceive yourself? Where 1 is almost salaried employees and 10 is completely independent. So the average score is 8, so quite high. And objective criteria, you can see that in all the country, at minimum 60% fulfill each criteria. And in some countries, there are more than 90%. We try also to make an estimation of bogus self-employed, define at risk of being bogus workers who have less than 4 parameters of independence, 1, 2, or 3. So, and they are quite small. The biggest one is in Belgium, 16, and the Netherlands is small. Well, we can see that total independent, so with that fulfill all the 6 criteria, has a very high percentage. The majority of them mainly work at home, and also less than 50% work with a stable network of colleagues. So they are very isolated, and they are at risk of loneliness and of loss of know-how, and without having possibility of updating their skill, working with other people. We have seen that many of them are very satisfied with the job and the job they do, the independence and so on, but they're not satisfied at home with their income. But if we look at how much they earn, we can understand why. The majority has a gross annual income that is 30,000 euro or less. Gross annual income. No. The only exception is the Netherlands that have a quite different situation. And it's linked to two things mainly. First of all, the continuity of work. Almost half don't work continuously, with the exception of Netherlands. And the problem of low compensation. In all the country, low compensation was one of the first three problems. And many of them said that they have a problem of low compensation. So welfare. We asked them if they feel protected by the welfare. So for the unemployment, they don't feel protected in any country. Only salaried workers that work under UC or LMI feel that they are protected because they have the same protection of employed workers. For pension, illness and accident, they don't feel completely protected, let's say. Why? First of all, because the welfare system is designed for salaried workers. But second, always, or I mean often, IPs don't earn enough money to pay adequate contribution to have a social security benefit, to be entitled to have the benefit. So for the representation, they said that there are different subjects in different countries that try to give answer to their needs, but they are too weak. So they suggest to do a network strategies. So conclusion, they are high wires, more than high wire, because they have high skill, they have the job they like, they have the independence, but also low compensation and discontinuity. That means low income, multiple job and poor welfare. And nobody at the moment who is able or has the strength to represent their interest on policymakers. Okay, that's it. Thank you.